discuss the Chapter 3 entitled Selecting the Research Method. In doing a research, after having identified the research problem, built a theory, formulating a hypothesis, this time, the researcher will decide what suitable methods are useful for his or her study. The researcher must first decide whether the proposed research will be primarily applied or basic.
Basic research tends to be theoretical in nature and concerns itself primarily with theory construction, hypothesis testing, and production of new, generalizable knowledge. Applied research tends to be more pragmatic and emphasizes providing information that is immediately usable in the resolution of actual problems, which may or may not have application beyond study. Action research.
Action research is a major type of applied research. It has a direct application to the immediate workplace of the researcher to develop new skills or new approaches to solve problems with direct application to the classroom or working world setting.
There are six basic steps in action research.
The following are: first, defining the problem; second, reviewing the literature; third, formulating hypothesis; fifth, arranging research setting; next, establishing measurement techniques and evaluation criteria; and at last, analyzing the data and evaluating the results.
Evidence-based research
reflects both the efforts of practitioners who consume the results of research in making those decisions and the efforts of applied researchers who strive to produce the research evidence intended for use by practitioners.
Evaluative research
of knowledge within a specific program or project, practical or utilitarian in nature, implicit if not explicit, usually limited in terms of time and space.
Two types of evaluative research, namely one, summative evaluation, and two, formative evaluation. Qualitative research
tends to apply a more holistic and natural approach to the resolution of a problem. Give more attention to the subjective aspects, usually observation and the interview.
Specific research methods. Here are the most commonly used research methods in libraries.
The first one is survey research.
Research strategy where ANA collects data from all or part of a population to assess the relative incidence, distribution, and interrelations of naturally occurring variables. Experimental research. The researcher manipulates at least one independent variable, controls other relevant variables, and observes the effect on only or more dependent variables. Historical research. Reconstructing the past systematically and objectively by collecting, evaluating, verifying, and synthesizing evidence to establish facts and reach defensible conclusions. Operations research. Used to identify optimal solutions to real problems, utilizing analytical mathematical techniques. Here are the steps in operation researchers. Modeling. A model is an abstraction, a mental framework for analysis of a system. System analysis utilizes operations research type techniques and typically takes into consideration the objectives and performance, the environment, the resources, components, and the management of the entire system. Case study. Investigating phenomena when one a large variety of factors and relationships are included. To know basic laws exist to determine which factors and relationships are important. Three, when the factors and relationships can be directly observed. Delphi study. Procedure using sequential questionnaires by which the opinions of experts can be brought to bear on issues that are essentially non-factual. Content analysis. Analysis of the manifest and latent content of a body of communicated material as a book or film through a classification, tabulation, and evaluation of its key symbols and themes in order to ascertain its meaning and probable effect. Bibliometrics, the application of mathematics and statistical methods to books and other media of communication. Task-based research, designed to utilize multiple research methods within the linguistics, teaching and learning, and human-computer interface communities. Comparative librarianship. It provides the framework for conducting an appropriate comparative analysis. Technology-based research methods. Libraries and other information agencies embrace more and ever-changing technology, including social networking, and employ personnel with technological backgrounds. The profession must facilitate and encourage technology-based research like Web 2.0.